Welcome to Unit 6.5. In this unit, we want to inspect MOFs concerning their simplified underlying structures. We take the well-known example of MOF 5 once more. This is the underlying net of MOF 5. The structure of MOF 5 cannot be simplified any further. All the inorganic SBUs are contracted to 6 connecting points. The organic SBUs are only 2 connecting and not branching points. Therefore, they are condensed to simple lines. This now somewhat looks like a cubic primitive Bravais lattice. But why would we actually want to reduce the structures as far as presented here? Well, imagine that you mix a linker and some metal ions together. And you use 2 different solvents. And in each of the solvents you get a different crystal structure of the resulting MOF. Upon inspection of the crystal structure, you notice that in both structures you still have the same organic SBU and you also have exactly the same inorganic SBU. But somehow the overall structure is different. How would you explain this difference to your colleague? Right. You need to tell them how the building units are arranged to each other. This is an example for this problem that comes from our research group again. Our colleague used the same linker and used copper nitrate as a metal source in both cases. But while in the first case she used dimethyl acetamide as a solvent, she used a mixture of water, ethanol, and dimethyl formamide in another experiment. This results in very different structures. Both are comprised of the same secondary building units, namely this linker and these copper pedal wheels. Again, I show you a greatly reduced structure of both MOFs. This structure has the FOF net as an underlying structure, and this one has the STX net. Now, what do we mean when we talk about nets? This falls in the area of topology. Topology is the mathematical study of shapes and topological spaces. It looks at structures in a very abstract way. The definition is that topology is an area of mathematics concerned with the properties of space that are preserved under continuous deformations, including stretching and bending, but not tearing or gluing. Huh? What does this mean? Let me explain this to you with an actual net. If we want to describe this net, we would explain how each of these nodes is connected to the rest. And it doesn't affect the connectivity if we spread this net far apart or compress it. From a topological point of view, the net remains the same. But what is forbidden is to cut loose any of these nodes, or glue them together, or anything like that. Because this would then change the connectivity of the system. Now let's look at some MOFs and their underlying nets. You have already seen the underlying net of MOF 5, and I already told you that this does actually represent a cubic primitive arrangement. Nets are commonly denoted with a 3-letter code, and the abbreviated name for the underlying net of MOF 5 is PCU. Sometimes the name of a net gives an indication from what this net is derived, as in this case, but in most cases the names of the nets are arbitrarily chosen. This is the DIA net. This is the underlying net of this MOF. You have seen this structure before. Can you remember what it is? Right, this is the structure of diamond, and hence the abbreviation DIA. Another common net is the MbO net. This net got its name from the similarity to niobium oxide, or NbO. This net can be found in MOFs where square planar SBUs are present that are perpendicular to each other, like in this MOF right here. Most of the nets we have shown you so far got their names by their similarity to another structure. While this kind of nomenclature makes some nets easy to memorize, this also has one drawback: when a net does not have any resemblance with a known crystal structure. And you might ask yourself, is there a more systematical approach? The answer is yes, there is. We will show you the principles of determining and describing a net in the next unit.